book, if you can state your name, spell it.
Something different.
You know those clips we have on the internet, like with Taylor, that 30, 60 seconds? Start with your name, make sure you get 3/4 in, and the URL on the mail. Francis, grandpermission.com. Yeah, and just add lib. Why?
On the way
out. On the way out. Make sure you say the way in. Hi, I'm here to talk to you about Francis. And so just add live a couple of wild texts, 30, 60 seconds that can be cut down to use on the internet as promos.
I'm Maria Lisi, and I'm here to talk to you about the Mirada's Rainforest Project. And we're really excited to have everyone on board for this great film that is exposing the truth that business group leaders do not want you to know about the saving the rainforest. More information is at miradasrainforestshouldnotdie.com.
How was it on time, do you know? About 45?
On the timing for the statement?
Time.
Let's do one more, maybe a little bit more condensed.
Well, no, that was actually kind of short because the other ones were running her 60s. So
okay.
She's got
breathing. Maybe say a little bit more.
Yeah, I just add live a little more. If you were telling a friend about this project, if you were telling your mom or dad about this project, how would you, for the first time, explain it to you? What best friend?
What do you want to call it? Like an epic documentary? Or
is that how you would describe it to a friend? I'm trying not to put words in your mouth. I want you to be your own spokesperson on this. So, let's see how well you sell the passion of you now.
Okay.
Because you're not selling my script, you're selling your script.
Let's see her epic sales job on getting people to run to theaters now.
Okay, you have speed.
I'm Maria Lisi, and I'm here to talk to you about the Mirada's Rainforest Epic Film Project, where we're working to save the rainforest in Indonesia and really bring about environmental change. You can find more information at miradasrainforestshouldnotdie.com.
Good. You can do a longer one. Maybe you could talk about 2 degrees or sea levels rising. I don't know. What's comfortable to you?
Okay.
If you were picking from doing... I'd rather we run long, we can always clip it.
Mm-hmm.
So if you do a 2-minute piece, that's okay.
Okay.
We can always edit.
Okay.
That's how I pulled theirs, was editing out of just a clip.
Hi, I'm Maria Lisi, and thanks for joining us on this epic movie about environmental change called Mirada's Rainforest Should Not Die. As we all know, things are going on around with nature, with flooding and storms and climate change. There's a lot of stuff that's going on, and we have to work together by recycling and putting in place regulations for planting rainforest trees that are being demolished and wiped out. And we're all working together to bring about these policies and changes. So join us and find out more information at miradasrainforestshouldnotdie.com.
Good. Anything else you want to try? You want to try your alter read piece? Can you do the alter read piece? One is on the site and does that like long 5 minutes. You should, it's a good piece.
Okay, so let's start again with, we've already got your slate, so we don't need that. Did you spell your last name correctly for them? Okay, good. So we're still rolling?
Yeah.
Okay, so Maria, our forefathers could have prevented this, but they felt it was our responsibility to take care of ourselves because money was too important to them. So they sold out the future. How does that feel?
Feels like it's short-term gains for long-term losses. Stuff like that can only go on for a little while.
So what would you say to world leaders if you could talk to the people who are the decision makers of companies and businesses to impress upon them the absolute urgency of change?
I would say to the world leaders that policies have to be put into place where the environment is protected, and that needs to happen now because there is such a rapid rate of destruction that needs to happen. Business can still flourish, but these regulations need to be in place.
Well, if we could people stop bootlegging teak wood and baboons. Do you realize this year alone, between 500 to 1500 life forms will become extinct? How does that feel?
It's really shocking that that many species will be extinct soon, and we don't know even what they are, what value that they have to our world. They could have medicinal cures, they're living creatures. And the fact that things are disappearing so quickly, the world can't handle it. Things are just going to implode on themselves.
When you saw the eye from the sky from NASA of Hurricane Patricia, what did that image of the worst storm in history sing to you?
Well, the image of the angry eye of the storms, it's all these red colors surrounding it. It definitely looks like a lot of destruction. And we're very lucky that here in the States, we've had some storms, but we've been able to recover from them. But other areas where they're just completely wiped out and desolated, the environment is talking to us. There's a message with that.
We have about 1.2 degrees, and if we fracture that, bioecho meltdown begins, which means glaciers melt. New foreign things that have been sealed in ice for centuries, we have no idea what those contaminants might be like, will be set free, while we devastate the rainforests that give us oxygen. So if we're adding more people to planet Earth, and there's now over 7 billion people, and we cut out 40% of our lung capacity, what happens to those with asthma and other breathing problems already? Unfortunately, we've become anesthetized. We're the generation where it's no longer we, it's no longer us, it's no longer family. It's me, get out of the way, I want it now, what's taking so long? How do we change all of that dysfunction into positive momentum to change what's happening in the world today?
Well, I think to change things, to make them more positive, where people work together rather than being so individual focused, part of the start of that is seeing what impact individuals have, whether that's for the negative or for the positive. So if it comes down to individuals, each person, like how much trash does each person produce a year, and actually seeing like figures, like visual figures to demonstrate that. And then also seeing how people can change that for the positive, whether it's recycling or some rainforest on the other
What do you say to the person who says, I'm one person, what can I do? Do we all have a moral responsibility to recycle and be more frugal with the resources of the earth, or are we entitled to have whatever the hell we want? What about simple things people can do, like find the energy vampires in their house and fix them, or not throw cigarette butts out the window, or let the oil drain into the ditches that go out to the oceans that kill mammals or contaminate food sources? What about the naysayers, especially, unfortunately, in other countries that have not had the benefits of the United States, who are saying this is more U.S. propaganda so they can control our resources? Yeah, why can't we have the way of life in America? We got a lot of way to make money right now. So why can't we sell our stuff like America sold theirs? Who are the biggest abusers and polluters in the world?
I would think that the biggest abusers and polluters in the world probably are big businesses.
Yes, America is the most gluttonous, polluting, and we're not adhering to the international treaties. We won't sign the treaty on caps because it may affect our business. What do you say when you realize that your own government deregulated the EPA where now you can't use scientific evidence to show contamination in air, water, soil, or mineral?
I think the right information needs to be out there. If there is scientific evidence showing
that... It's against the law now in the United States. You cannot use it in a court. It's been voted into law.
I don't understand why that would do anyone any good.
Well, our government made a mistake. They appointed heads of Exxon and Shell and major corporations to an advisory board of the EPA, and the recommendation was they couldn't find other companies because they'd end up having to find themselves, and so it would be better if we just got rid of scientific evidence, and then there would be no more fines, and Congress approved. No kickbacks going on there, is there? Well, unfortunately, it's going to take a unity of nations, kind of like United Nations, who were supporting us on this film, and their charter says they support humanitarian rights, the environment, all the things we're doing with this film. How does it feel knowing that we were invited to be in Paris for this global warming summit, and then when they found out we were going to tell the truth, they said, no way?
Fabricate the lies,
right,
based upon
what they needed to pass the regulations.
All those Republicans saying there's no such thing as global warming. That's because of Exxon.
Even they were reading the reports that said it was in there. But because they got campaign contributions, they decided to let it slide. Those little perks to the islands, you know.
Saying it was the worst corporate
debauchery. And you know what? And you know how many are going to go to jail?
Probably none.
Probably none. Because they all were on the payroll. How does that feel? Knowing that so many people are on the payroll and that the dollar is more important than the extension of humanitarian efforts or human life, let's sell out the planet and burn it to the ground.
Reputable and doing things the right way for them to gain more customers.
Okay, if you can make a note where we left off on that.